over to the edge because it looks like it needs pushing uphill anyway. And I think the cable looked like it was going to hit the tower, so I'd rather be facing uphill so I can see if it actually will. At least if it gets close when I'm going uphill, I can back off. But going downhill, if you go downhill and then the machine doesn't want to reverse back up, then you're committed to dragging your cable across the tower. interesting to see what happens at the top, because I don't have the active winch and the machine will want to be pulling me that way. So I'd say this right hand track's going to spin when I get close to the top. The suspension seat wants to push you into the ceiling and you can't reach the throttle. That was a problem in the old ones too. What a great time for that to happen. Thank you. like you, but I don't think it should be that stiff.
Thank you.
over there, and if I've got the piston pulley, I can put on active winch and it'll start pulling like that. You can't do that with this. You've got to rely on the winch tension and your skill with the blade and the tiller, basically. These will pirouette until they either tip over or you get to the bottom. So it's quite important as you come down to keep your tracks spinning at a constant speed. So if you let go of the sticks too much, if you're trying to come back too slowly and then one track locks, you'll start sliding on that track and then you're in for some new underpants, I guess. Maybe a new snowcat too. Going to be really hard to fix. Visibility out the back of these is way better than the old Leitwolf. You couldn't see shit behind you in an old Leitwolf. Well, the winch anyway. But these, the mirrors are set up a lot better. This mirror's really good. I don't know how they've done it, but you can see a lot more over your shoulder as well. I have a feeling the winch drum sits lower, but I could be wrong. And the windows are clearer. They've gotten rid of the big black heater bars in the middle of the side doors, so you can see out a lot better. So I've improved the visibility a lot. That's something I really hated in the old ones. And the camera's a lot better too. The old camera, you basically drive for about an hour and then it would be covered in snow and you couldn't see anything. But this one's stayed clean and you can see pretty well out of it. Blade creeps up and down by itself though. Wow, okay. It does creep up by itself. I don't know if you can see that on the camera. I thought that was just me pulling back on the stick, but it is actually going up by itself. I've also noticed when you park it, if you park and idle for a little while, the blade starts pushing itself down. I didn't realize it was actually doing it until you go to take off. You lift the blade up and the front of the cat drops. It's a bit strange. I don't know why it does that. Actually, as you can see the winch drum in the camera, pretty clearly, so you can see if the cable's reeling out and reeling back in properly. So I have had problems with the old one sometimes. If the pulleys freeze and the winch is trying to push more cable out, but the pulley up top isn't spooling properly, the cable will start to bird's nest behind the winch drum, and then you end up in a bit of trouble. This one hasn't done that yet. But if it does, I'd be able to see it on the camera, so that's a bonus. Because you can't, in the piston bullies, you can see through a little window the front of the drum directly behind you, so you can set it up with a mirror. But in these, because you sit in the center and the winch drum is in the center as well, you can't look over your shoulder to see the cable or the drum. So that's good, that's smart. Definitely beats the 600 as cab noise. It's way quieter in this cab. It doesn't bother me as much, but I mean, it's also the 600's got a really good stereo system, so you just crank that up if you're annoyed by the noise. But it is good for your ears to have a quieter cab, so that is a good thing about this machine. Nice and quiet. You could probably have a good conversation with somebody in here and not have to raise your voice too much. We'll see what it's like talking to a camera. mirror, you're also looking away from the machine just because of the way they were positioned. They were sort of in, or so you look through the window at them rather than out the side window, so you couldn't see what was behind you. But this, I've got the mirrors set up and I can see the windrow that I'm aiming for in both mirrors, which is good. That means they're crossing over. Somebody sat here and thought about it, which is good. That's what you need to, that's what you need to see in a machine development process, is people actually trying to use the machine and understanding the problems that we might face. I don't know about the self-raising blade though, that's interesting. Negative to having the mirrors out the side windows. Obviously the positives are that you can see better, but the negatives are if the mirrors or the windows are getting fogged up with snow, you can't see your mirrors. You can't open the windows. Thank you. fix it with my machine, but I don't know if I can fix it with this. because you've got a winch, you can't spin your tracks or anything, but you can. Because the winch can't pull the whole machine up, it still needs some mechanical traction and good snow underneath it.